Good everyone, welcome to a very thought tutorial on HTML. This is Migrit Moti from Smart Academy. Now in our last video, I told you that when we come back, we'll start designing a website. Now I look at it, it will be best if we have a project we're working on whereby we'll cover a lot of things about HTML. So we're going to learn a lot of things. So having talked a little, let's get to work. Now in designing websites, there are some basic things you must know. Now we're using HTML5, and there are some basic things. There's not much difference, but let's just get to work first. So in code is HTML5, the first thing to do is to declare your documentation type, which is called doc type. Now please mind you, HTML is not case sensitive, so you can use either uppercase or lowercase, it doesn't matter, it will still give you the same thing. So you say document type, which is document declaration. So say document type, doc type is equal to what? HTML, because that's the document we're using here. Do we understand? Then go to the next line. So now that we are done with the HTML, now let's go and add a language. Let's define our language for HTML so they know the language we are using. So you do HTML language for, so lang is short for language here, is equal to quotation in en for English. So let me explain it to you as I've mentioned earlier on. So I have a picture here on my browser, which I'm going to use to explain this to you. You see here we have the P, it is called the start tag. So it is the start tag, that's the tag you are dealing with, and P stands for paragraph. So then this class is an attribute, you know, like, okay, you are just giving an attribute to your site which you refer to later. It means later on, the time will come by whereby we refer to this attribute called class, and then equal to assigning, we are trying to assign a value to the attribute, which is 4, and that's the value. So when you declare something, when you have an attribute, you have to put the equal sign and then the quotation. So take note, anywhere you have to be equal to in your HTML, you have to put quotation, then the value. Understand? And then this is the content of the tag, whatever. So you open tag, you closing tag, and this is the content of everything. And then the end tag, which I've mentioned earlier on, or the closing tag. So I hope you understand. So let's go back to our notepad. Okay, so now I've explained this to you now. Let's go next to our next tab and create the head tag. It's called head. But now, mind you, whatever I do here now, there's no result. Okay, let me save it. Save. Come to my browser and refresh. You see there's nothing. It not display anything. Why? Because there's nothing we've written for it to display yet. We're just only defining something. So that once the browser is reading our HTML file, once the HTML engine is loading, it will understand what to do, to know how to handle our file. So now we've created the head tag. Now what next? Let's close it. So /, then the head, and then you close. Okay, so now I want to create the title. Let me save this again. Save, please. Next time I may not come here and do the save again. I will do Control S in my browser and see in my on my text editor. Take notes. So what's our title here? facecode.html. That's not the title, that's actually the name of our file. Now I want to change this name, so let's give it a title. You know, just like when you go to other websites, you see the title written on it and stuff like that. So I want to give our own a title. So now I'll come to the HTML file and open a tag called what? Title. Close it. Then give it a value. I want to give it a title. Okay. Let's say Smart Academy. Then HTML tutorial. This title is kind of long, not everything we should, but anyway, that's just it. HTML tutorials. So let me close my title, / title, and then I will save. Control S, come to my browser, refresh. Now can you see it? Smart Academy HTML tutorials. We've given it a title. It's not showing the name of our code again. Let's go back to my HTML document. What next? We've done that. So that tag again is called the body tag. then we'll close the word body tag. Now, you know, just like your body, we have the head, which is from your head to the neck, and then from the neck downward again we have the body, and then the legs or foot. So also is your website. We have the head, we have the head, which is somewhere around here. Don't mind me, I'm just using this, but you can define, you want to define it here. We have the head, then the body where all the contents of your site is, and then we have the footer, which is the bottom part of your code. So now in our body, what do we want to do? We want to display a text, maybe to welcome somebody to our site. So I'm going to put it, okay, and I want the text to be big. Now we have what to call the heading tags. Heading tags determines how big your text will be, and it starts from what we call the H1. All right, I will show you everything here now. We have the H1, which is actually the biggest of them all. Let's say this is a heading tag. This is a heading tag, and then go to the second line. Sorry, I'm feeling kind of lazy. As we all know, they say programmers, we are lazy people. Yeah, let me prove them true for once. So I'll just paste this and then change the value here to 2. Change this value to 2 also. Then go to the next line. Paste. Change the value to 3. Oh, sorry. 3. Change this one also to what? 3. Go to the next line. Change the value here to 4. And then change this one also to 4. Go to the next line. Paste. Change the value here to 5. Change the value here to 5. Then go to the next line, paste. Change the value here to 6. Change the value here to 6. So then I save my work and I refresh my page. Now can you see? H1, our H1 tag, which is the first one, appears bigger, followed by the H2, which is this one here, a bit smaller. Sorry, this is my H1, forgive me. Ah, this old age is dealing with me. Ah, so this is the H1, as you can see, bigger. Then H2, this is it. H3, this is it. H4, this is it. And then H5, this is it. And then H6, this is it. Now remember, I said that it's from H1 to H5, right? Now you're like, but you have H6 here. Yes. But H6 is so tiny, it's not readable. So it means the acceptable one should be what? H5, because at least H5, even though it's small, but at least it's a bit readable compared to H6. Or let's even try something crazy, you know. I love doing crazy things. Let's try H7. That'll be very, very tiny. I wonder we'll be able to read that. So I'll save and come and refresh. Oh, it was so tiny that HTML had to even ignore it. Oh my god. So you see, H7 was so tiny that HTML was like, oh my god, which man on earth will be able to read that? And so they have to decide to just ignore it and just read it as a plain text, not as a header text again. So it means even if I should remove this heading tag and refresh my browser, this text will still, the size will still remain what? Normal. Are you seeing it? I'm refreshing, reload. Sorry, Control R to reload or refresh. It did not change because H7 was damn tiny. So actually, so it means my statement was wrong. It's from what? H1 to H6. Whoa, that's great. Now I've found the heading tag. Let me clean everything here and then leave just our H1 tag. And then what will I type? I will say welcome to my site. That's my I'm stingy. To our site. Our site. Welcome to our site. Pom pom pom. Save this. Come here and refresh. Refresh. Did you see it up here? Welcome to our site. Well, isn't this cool? It looks cool. Now, so what's next thing we need to add here again? What next? Maybe body tag. So let me put our motto. Okay, sorry, the name of our site. Now what's the name of our but we're supposed to appear before welcoming a user to our site. What am I doing? So I'll come to my head tag. and write the name of our site. So what's the name of our site? Okay, I'll just build a site for my school. So I'm going to call it Smart. Oh, sorry. Forgive me. So I'll just put Smart Academy. Oh, what am I typing? Smart Academy. I will save this. Now, mind you, I did not put this in the tag. It's not in the tag, so it means it will still work. I seen it. The name here appears Smart Academy. But car is looking small. So when somebody comes to my site, the first thing he will read will be this one before even this, because size matters. So what will I do? I'll make it what? Bigger. I'll make it very big. So what will I do? I'll put what? H1. I'll give it H1 tag, which is heading one tag, which is, as we know, is the biggest. H1, then come and close it back on the H1 tag again. H1, close it. So this one, it means once I do that, they'll compete. So I'll make this one what? H2. It can be bigger than the name of my site. H2, then save it. And then refresh. Now can you see this? Smart Academy. So that's the name of our site. It has appeared here. So now, what next again do we need to do? Okay, color. Now in HTML we can give background color. We can give it, you know, a color like just plain white. It's looking white and black. Are we in the olden days? We've passed the age of using white and black. Let's give it some kind of colors. So let me give it a color here. Come to your body tag, then we type BG. And BG stands for background. You know, short from shortcut. I told you programmers we are lazy, so we like to shorten things. So instead of writing background, now it's way too long. So what do we use? BG color. Color, no you? Yeah, in programming, our color doesn't have you. When you're programming, there's nothing like you, color, it's just BG color. It's equal to, what next? Quotation, remember what I told you? Quotation, and then, which color should we give ourselves? Which color? Blue, red, green, black, yellow, purple, or, sorry, I'm not good at colors, I'm very poor in color combination. So let's just do something crazy. So I'm going to give it background color green. Save it. Come here and you refresh. Our site is not having green color. But come on, our text is black. Color of our text on our background does not really look cool. But anyway, let's continue with time. When we get to CSS, now to edit such, I have a very nice view of our site. So I think we'll stop here, guys, for today. Welcome to our next class. We'll come on creating form, because once we have a new user in our site, you should be able to register and then log in before you can access anything in the site. So thank you guys for watching. See you guys in our next tutorial. Thank you.